Once again, I welcome you to English class. Let's start up with the book exercises of the chapter which we completed day before yesterday, and we already have done the question answers. So now today we'll be taking up book exercises. Let's move on to the exercise number A2, right? So here, what is the direction? Complete the following in your own words. So now there are some sentences, incomplete ones. You need to complete these sentences in your own words. Here I am helping you out to do these. First one is, village dogs were wide awake and watchful. So now we need to tell about that because village dogs were awake, what was the result of that? So the wolf was not getting food to eat, right? So here I have written, so the wolf was starving. That means he was not getting the food to eat. He was hungry. Second, the wolf met the house dog. The wolf met the house dog. So here, what can be the answer? Where he met, right? Or something about the dog to whom he met. So we were told in the story that he was wandering quite far off from his house. So that's what I have taken up in this answer. Whose house was quite far? He met that dog whose house was quite far, right? So it was given in the story. The wolf was impressed by the dog's appearance. So when he was impressed, so then what he himself decided to do? So that should be the answer here. So he praised him and talked softly to him, right? So he talked pleasingly to him was the content which we got from the chapter. So now here we have written it in our own words. So the next sentence is, the dog tried to tempt the wolf by what he was getting the temptation of that feast, that food. That yummy food he was telling, that tidbits he was telling, that you would be hardly doing anything. In return, you will be getting lot of tidbits, right? So here I have taken that, telling him that he will have tidbits of every kind, like chicken bites, meat bites. And then fifth one, the mark on the dog's neck was made by, the mark on the dog's neck was made by what? You need to mention here by what. So by that collar, he mentioned that by that collar to which his chain was fastened. So here it is made by, right? So kindly correct it. And moreover, it is in the book. The sentence is in the book. So you can get that corrected from the book even. So go to the sixth one. The chain was used to. For what purpose the chain was used? To take control over the dog. So to control him. Simple. Next one is, the wolf ran back into the woods because... Why did he decide not to go to that house or not to go to the house, or he decided to live in the woods? What was the reason? Because he wanted to live with the liberty only. He didn't want to get into a prison. So then for him, liberty was everything, right? So these were the sentences of exercise A2. So now here we are there with exercise B1, and this is, here are some common idioms used in English. Can you guess their meanings? Fill in the blanks with the correct meanings from those given in the box. So first of all, let me tell you the direction that you need to guess the meanings of the idioms. And what are idioms basically? Idioms are like, you know, muhavras in Hindi. So idioms are those typical statements which are used to give impression in your language and which are used at a particular moment, at a particular situation to put the instance in a clearer version, right? So here what we will be doing that we need to and mind it, what is the difference between idiom? If you will be taking single word of that, like one word you will be getting the meaning, other word you will be getting the meaning, and then you will be combining, you will not get the meaning of the idiom. So idiom when is used in 3 to 4 words together, then the meaning is changed. So then you need not to dissect that and infer the meaning. So those meanings are fixed. So now here it is, you need to match the idioms with their correct meanings. So here first is burning the candle at the at both ends. So here you need to match it with the meaning. So but here, as I am not taking up the book on the screen, so I'm just simply writing the answer in front of that. So accordingly, you'll be looking onto the table in your book, and then you may write the answer. You may write the numbering in the column. Right? Got it? So now here the answer of this is working very hard day and night. It is, I guess, on second number in your box, in your book, right? So here, working very hard day and night means burning the candle at both ends, okay? So here, if we dissect these words, I mean separate these words, then we will not get this meaning, but it is specified. The meaning is specified by some ancient English language learners. So they have inferred the meaning it like this, working very hard day and night. Second is at a snail's pace. Here you can get the idea from the words only. At a snail's pace means how does a snail walk? What is the speed of a snail? Very slow. So that means very slowly, right? So then third one is raining cats and dogs. Cats and dogs means when you know the cats and dogs are fighting, they run very fastly. So then it is the meaning of this is raining cats and dogs means very heavily, raining very heavily, right? So then fourth one is smell a rat. That means a foul smell. Suspect something is wrong. So here the answer is not related to the smell. Look, here it is, suspect something is going on wrong. Something wrong is going on. So then fifth one is pay through the nose. So now what is the meaning of this? Pay a lot of money for something. Pay through a nose. Have you heard about it? Naak tak pani aa gaya. Naak mein dam kar diya. What is that? That is to get disturbed. So pay a lot of money for something. So here the answer is lot of money. That means above your limits. So that is the meaning. The sixth one is turn over a new leaf. That means to take a good, to take a new start. Turn over a new leaf, when you change the, when you turn the page, then you start writing a new topic or something. So that is why it is make a fresh start, make a new start. So here were these. So let me tell you students, so after this matching of the idioms, you will be getting a, you would have got the fill in the blanks. So using the idioms given below. So here I have taken up those fill in the blanks and which we have done idioms from those idioms we need to, now we have got to know the meanings, so now we have to fix those idioms in the sentences given. So now here, Sanjay promised he would never lie again and would now. What will he do now? He will not do this. Now he will turn over a new leaf. We have just covered up. And then the second one is, though the milkman promised that he had not mixed any water in the milk, my mother, although he was saying that he has not mixed milk in that, mixed water in the milk, but still his mother could sense that something is wrong in this, right? So that is, smelt a rat. Then the third one is, we could not go out to play because the field was wet and field was wet because it was raining cats and dogs. You are right, students. So now then the fourth one is, my friend has been preparing for the final exams and try to guess, burning the candles at both ends, right? That is working very hard. And then the child did not want to go to school. In fact, he was walking at a snail's place. Isn't it? In fact, he was walking at a snail's place because he didn't want to go to school. Very slowly he was walking. Sixth one is, my father had to dash for the new house as it turned to be more expensive than he had expected. So now here, what should be the answer? Pay through the nose. I just explained you. Heavy amount, huge amount. So now come to the exercise B3. Here is a list of words. So you need to find out the opposites from the story. The opposites of those words from the story. So opposites are also called antonyms. You remember? Opposites are also called antonyms. Right? So now here, we are taking up the words. First one is sleepy. And the opposite to that we find in the story, awake. As the dogs were awake and watchful in the whole night. The wolf was not getting food to eat. So that is awake. And then second is in high spirits. Which the opposite of that is downhearted. In high spirits, self-confidence, full of confidence, overconfident. Downhearted, very low in confidence, do not have confidence. So criticizing, that is complimenting. You are criticizing others that you haven't done well. So here you are praising the other, that is complimenting. So the wolf complimented the house dog for his good appearance. So now here, happily is miserably. The house dog told the wolf that, why don't you leave this life of the woods when you are living here miserably, isn't it? So miserably. The fifth one is unkind, very clear, kind. And then sixth is laughed. Laughed is wept. Right? So seventh one is unfastened. Fastened. That is just, you need to remove the prefix from that word. So that is, this was the verb for today. So you will be doing these exercises and this is your homework for today. Thank you.